is creating a great legacy for Ohio's tourism industry. I mean, this is a golf course that is going to be the only one to have hosted the Solheim Cup, Ryder Cup, and now the President's Cup. 150,000 expected visitors, $50 million in potential economic impact for the state of Ohio, and 5,000 to 7,000 international visitors coming. That's huge. And we want all of them to come here, have a great time, and then go home and tell all their friends that Central Ohio is the place to be.
How about Outback Steakhouses? Any of those here?
I think there's one.
One?
It's out of town.
Well, we have a lot in Dublin. If you want to come to Dublin and see the Cup in 2013, you can stop at some Outback.
Reporters from all over the world are kind of logging their stories after today's events. Over 200 media here at the President's Cup representing over 50 countries. We have that to look forward to when they come to Dublin, Ohio. You can imagine the exposure that Dublin, Central Ohio, and the state of Ohio is going to get from media covering the event in 2013. And they estimate over 500 million viewers are going to watch this event this weekend alone. So,
and you know, when the media comes into town, it's an international media. We've got, they're coming from all over the world, including Europe, even though European players don't play. So, having lived in Columbus, I know that Dublin has a lot of great restaurants, a lot of great places to visit, great hotels. Columbus has a lot to offer, and I think people are really going to enjoy, if they haven't been to the Memorial, or they haven't been to one of the other events at Muirfield Village, they're really going to enjoy not only Muirfield Village, but all the things around it, because, I mean, it's just, it's a neat city, it's a growing city, it's a vibrant city.
It's going to be a big event. And 2013, when we have these rowdy Australians, in particular, these Melbourne people, what will we expect from them?
There's big crowds here every day, but they love their golf, and they'll be well behaved because, when we come to see the golf Australians, we're there to see the golf, not to play up. So it'll be a lot of fun, and they've got a good sense of humour, the Australian crowd, so it'll be a lot of fun.
Great win!
Yeah, well, number one, we've been working on this for 5 years, and it's finally coming to Columbus and Dublin in 2013, and what they'll get to see is great international competition with all the right things in place. Goodwill, ambassadorship, all showcasing through the game of golf, and the Americans and the international teams had a great time this week playing incredible golf, and at the end of the day, shook each other's hands and said, well done. And that's what we should expect when it comes to our way in 2013.
It's been a fabulous week. I don't think you could have asked for better competition, for better variety of weather, and the international exposure for Melbourne. It's not going to be either the international exposure for Columbus and for Dublin and Central Ohio and for all of our communities back home. So it's been a great week. We were honored to be a part of it.
And how we did this is me as captain, by just saying thank you all, and we'll see you in 2 years in Ohio. Thank you.
What up, friend? Ladies and gentlemen, once again, a collective round of applause for the United States of America.